WordPress is a great tool to create websites and blogs, but sometimes it can be really frustrating, especially if you are not technically savvy. Say the truth, how many times did you have the impulse to destroy your laptop because of WordPress? I totally had it. And since laptops are pretty expensive and I want you to save money and time as well, in this video I'll talk about how to create a website with WordPress easy and fast without writing a single line of HTML or CSS code. Is this a clickbait video? Let's find out. Welcome to the Growth Academy. My students and my clients, they already know that when I talk about WordPress, I always pronounce the word Elementor. And if you don't know what Elementor is, probably it's because you're not a subscriber of this channel. So click that red button that you see below this video. Do it. Anyway, Elementor is the best website builder on the market. Hands down. It's extremely flexible, it's extremely easy to use, but in this video I don't want to convince you to use Elementor. If you're skeptical about Elementor, you want to find out more, check one of the other videos that I shot. There should be a link around my face, I guess. As you may know, Elementor helps you to build, to design your page, your footer, your header, but this is just the tip of the iceberg. The biggest pain in the ass with WordPress is about structuring and designing your blog. You can use any of the templates that you can find online or you can find in WordPress, but if you went down the route, you know how frustrating it is to change even the slightest thing in a template somebody else built. Okay, if you are standing, sit down, because I'm gonna give you a breathtaking revelation. Elementor can help you designing and structuring your blog without writing a single code of CSS or HTML. And with designing and structuring your blog, I mean that you can move things around, you can add new section, you can delete other ones. Let me get on the computer and I show you. This is my blog and Elementor here is showing me just dynamic content. So everything you see here is to take a look at the structure. All the content you see is just created dynamically from Elementor. So if I want to change something in here, I'm gonna change the structure, never gonna touch the content. So as you can see here, you have the article on the left and some objects on the right. And if for some reason I want to add a few blocks on the top of my article, I can just create a section in there. I can take this object, put it on the top, get rid of the margin on the top. Then I can put something on the right, like the follow me section. I will get the follow me there and I will add the buttons as well. The button should be below the follow me. That's it. And I get rid of the margin on the top and I can align vertically this section. Here we go. So every article I have on my blog now, it will look like this. It will have this section on the top and then below it will have the article. But as well, if I want to change the bottom of my blog, I can take, for example, a list of posts and I add the widget and look at this. Now I will have the list of articles below every single article I will have on my blog. And again, this is just about the structure. But look how many widgets you have on the sidebar you can choose from. But what if you want to create a page from scratch, even without using a template? First of all, Elementor offers you a huge library of templates and objects that you can use for your pages. Just with this list, you don't have to design anything. But in case you want to start from scratch and you don't want to use any template, look how easy it is to create a page from scratch. Let's assume I want to create a landing page for a webinar. So I start from the empty canvas here. I'm gonna create one column where I'm gonna add a title, heading title, like this. Let's put some space between the title and the margin, the top margin of this window. And let's make it centered and a little bigger. All right. Then below I want to add a video and obviously the form to get into the webinar. Let's create two columns. Then I'm gonna search for the video and I add video at the left and automatically Elementor create an example video. Then I add some text on the right hand side and then I add my form. Form automatically adds the message, but I don't need a field for the message. I just want name and email. And then I'm gonna change the color of this button to to the action button and let's make it green like this. And I can personalize the button, like the sides for the text inside, change it and make it a little bigger. And let's create an icon that I would put at the left hand side of the text, like this one. That's great. Let's change the text to join the webinar, like this. And let's put some space between the icon and the text with this panel below. Great. It looks already amazing. And again, you can change every different aspect of each element. Like now I made it a little bold and smaller, so it looks perfect. Now, I want to put a countdown at the top because this is a landing page for a webinar. Here we go. I can get rid of days in this case, in case this page goes on just on the day of the webinar, and then I make it everything smaller because this is too much in your face. And let's make small numbers and the labels below as well. Pretty cool, huh? Now, let's change a little the size of this countdown. Let's make it a little narrower. Cool. Nice one. Then something else that I want to add is a progress bar. You know that cool progress bar that you usually have on webinars landing pages to tell you that you already finished your registration? And you have an element like this in Elementor as well. Here we go, our progress bar. I'm gonna change the text inside. I get rid of the title and it's already done. You know, I can change the color, I can put this green here instead of purple. And it looks amazing. Then, if I want to add something else, looks how many elements you have here, I want to add here, for example, the testimonial carousel. This is something cool for a webinar landing page. So I create a column, I search for the testimonial carousel, I put it down here, and Elementor automatically creates some example text for the quotes, and I can change everything of this, you know? Then the next thing I want to do is to put a background for the entire page. So let's see if I have something that is subtle, not too strong to put at the bottom of my page. Let's see, I have countless images here, a little too much, but I should have something here, I found it. Nice one. Okay, let's make it smaller. Let's choose cover here. Nice. And as I said before, you can personalize the page, I can change spaces, I can put some margin between the video and the progress bar, or some margin between the countdown and the title at the top. But the coolest thing of Elementor is that I can change the design for each device. Look at this, this is the tablet one. I can make the video 100% big, so it takes the entire space, entire width of the page, and then I change the sides of the form below, and look at this. Completely different from the desktop version. And this is just for the tablet, you know, it doesn't influence the desktop version. And again, I want to change the one on the mobile. Here, the countdown doesn't look so great, so I change a little how it looks, a little better. I can make the title a little bigger. Here we go. And obviously, the video should be a little closer to the rest. So, great like this, and look if I go back to the tablet version, it looks like I chose, and the desktop version is like this. Personally, I started my business creating websites for clients with Elementor. That's why I bought straight away the unlimited version of Elementor that at the moment is $199. Because if I could create a single website for a client per year, I would have already repaid my license. But if you want to hear more about how I started, how I grew my business with Elementor, well, there should be a link around the screen where you can check my other videos on this topic. And I think that right now is the right moment to subscribe to my channel and click on the bell. If you click on the bell, you will have a notification every time I will post a new video on this channel. Question of the day: What are you using right now to design your pages? Write your answer in the comments below. I will read all the answers. Share this video to any friend you think would like this video. And for the rest, I'll see you in the comments below, or I'll see you in the next video. Cheers, mate.